Welcome back to Obermatt Stock Investing. This is our first video in 4K, so enjoy the higher quality, and I hope you still get the same quality of research from us and you'll enjoy it for your own investing. Today, I'm actually doing something different. I'm not looking at the top 10 list. Something else happened last week. I bought something really exciting. I subscribed to a Tesla Model 3, which will probably arrive in about 3 years. Yes, I bought a Tesla 3 and I was wondering, should I invest in Tesla as well? Now, of course, when you go to the Obermatt value ratings, you will see that Tesla rates very, very bad on value. So when something rates really bad on value, I'm skeptical. And I actually have run the numbers. Let's have a look how Tesla looks in numbers. This is Tesla. Now, Tesla has a market capitalization of about 30 billion. This is about the market capitalization of Tesla. 30 billion is what you pay if you want to buy Tesla today. If you buy less, you get a fraction of that in your portfolio. Now, Tesla this year is going to make about 8 million in sales. 8 million in sales, which means 30 billion gets you 8 billion in sales. Now, let's look at another company that I like a lot. I'm a big fan of German cars. As a matter of fact, for the last 30 years, I have only driven and owned Southern Germany cars. And I'm very happy with it. Now, let's look at BMW. BMW has a market capitalization of 50 million. So you pay slightly more, you pay 50 billion to own BMW. But, you know, how much sales does BMW make? Well, BMW makes almost 100 billion in sales. I think it's about 94, roughly, this year, estimated. So you pay a little bit more, but you get a lot more business. Now, we all know the Tesla Model 3 is a really exciting car. I immediately subscribed, and what I've learned over the weekend was that Tesla, from all the subscription they have received, is going to make another 10 million, billion, maybe even a little bit more in sales when these Tesla 3 reservations materialize. Now, I think even if you're here, it doesn't make a lot of sense to pay, you know, almost the same price than for a company like BMW, which has a lot more business. There are exceptions to these rules. If Tesla manages to produce something that nobody can copy, like the iPhone, for instance, like a Google search, like Facebook, the Facebook social sharing application, then high valuations are actually justified. But if you think that the product that the company owns can actually be copied by a competitor, then a much higher valuation is not really justified. When it comes to cars, I really am a really true Tesla fan. I've only owned German cars, but now I've bought my first American car because I think it's really exciting what they do. As a matter of fact, I've been on their waiting list since it was possible to reserve the Model S. When I actually had to buy the Model S, I realized I want to invest the money in the Obermatt stock search, so I had to withdraw from my reservations. As a matter of fact, in the meantime, many, many Teslas are invested in our Obermatt stock search. But that doesn't mean that I think Tesla deserves that higher valuation. I could very well imagine that a company like BMW manages to bring electric cars to the market as well. As a matter of fact, BMW has launched an electric car and it is almost as good as a small Tesla. However, it still looks a little bit funny and it's still not good enough for a family. But that doesn't hold BMW back to develop a car in the near future that has all the features of a Model S, Model 3 from Tesla. That's why I think if I want to look at this decision, what car I like, I definitely like definitely like the Tesla better because it has the more advanced car on the market. But I like the stock of BMW much more because I get a lot more value for my money. This is why I bought BMW, as you can see from the screenshot of my electronic banking, which also shows you the last two stocks that I've bought over the last 2 weeks. I wish you good luck with your own investing, and I hope you can make the differentiation between what you like, what products you like, and what companies are sound investment ideas. Goodbye.